Welcome back to the Hunter Call of the Wild, and today I'm gonna give you guys an ultimate bow comparison part 1. In this video I'll be putting all the bows against each other and the crossbow and seeing which one of these has the best penetration and the best damage. And to do this I have done some arrangements. I have reset all my archery perks. And I haven't put any points in the pumping iron perk, because this skill alone makes all the bows basically equally powerful. So I want to have accurate numbers for this, so I didn't put any points in this one. And then I'm gonna use the recommended distance for the bows in this video, and that is 20 meters for the bows and 30 meters for the crossbow. And the basic differences between the bows is that the peak draw weight, this is down here, that differentiates between the bows, and the higher the number is, the stronger the bow basically is. So we have the longbow, which is at 60 pounds, we have the recurve at 70 pounds, and then we have the CB60 at 60 pounds, 65 at 65, CB70 at 70, and then the crossbow at 165 pounds. And the bows themselves don't have too much differences. As you can see, some recoils, some hip shots, accuracy. From what I've seen, that the higher pounds the bow has, the less accurate they apparently have. But from my experience, it doesn't really have too much effect on the bows. But the biggest difference comes from the arrows. Like the 300 grain arrows has penetration of 10. 350 has 15 penetration. 420 has already 50 penetration, 540 has 75, and 600 and 700 grain arrows have 90 penetration. So for this comparison, I have used the 420 and 540 arrows on red deer, and then 600 and 700 grain arrows for bison. The reason I'm not using any of the 300 and 350 grain arrows is that they're for small game, especially the 300 grain arrows. If you hit the target with the arrow, it's gonna die. So there's not much difference in like penetration and damage. But the only difference is that the 350 grain arrow goes to class 3. And that's a big deal, because the class 3 animals and this arrow is extremely underpowered. Like, I shot a feral goat less than 10 meters and it barely went to single lung, and the animal ran like 500 meters. So that arrow on the class 3 is basically, it's extremely underpowered, and I'd say it's completely useless. So I would highly recommend to use the 420s if you have to bow hunt the class 3 animals. Now let's go and take a look at those shots that I have done. First I have the red deer, and then we take a look at the bison. So here's the first animal that I have, the red deer. I'm gonna use the CB60. That's like roughly 20 meters, so that's the recommended distance for the bow. Then I'm using the 420 grain arrows. That just went basically through the whole deer. Seems like it's also double lung. And we pick it up. That's double lung hard shot from 21 meters. And it even hit the leg bone on the way, and it still went all the way through. So this is the lowest pound bow. And if you use it on the recommended distance, there's no trouble at all for this bow to penetrate completely through the animal. And then that red deer is coming. Then we are gonna use the CB65. I tried to take a similar shot, but I couldn't find red deer that gave me the broadside. So I took it straight like in front. And when we picked this guy up, it was a vital hit, so it went to the lung, and it went single lung. And it penetrated like really far. So I'm gonna say, if you have a broadside shot, that's just gonna completely go through the animal once again. And that was at 12.87 meters, so it was slightly closer than I wanted to have. But at 20 meters, I don't think it makes too much difference, at least on the red deer. And then I have the CB70 on a red deer. It's the powerful bow, and like as you can see, it went double long hard shot from 17 meters in an angle. Like, that's insane, and that's without the pumping iron skill too. So pretty nice looking red deer. I just saw that it has different antlers on both sides, so that's a funky fellow that I got. But yeah, recommended distance, and these bows have no trouble at all in the penetration and damage. And then we have 26 meters. I'm gonna use the crossbow and just, yeah. The penetration in the crossbow is insane. Like when we pick this guy up, you can see in an angle, it went through a bone, hit both lungs, it hit vertebra, and it went through the whole animal. Like, the crossbow is overpowered. If you want to just shoot an animal and not worry if it's gonna penetrate or do enough damage, just use the crossbow. And then we move on to the traditional bows. That's 28 meters. So that's coming closer, so let's take a proper shot on this guy. And that seems to be a single lung. And this is with the recurve bow. So let's pick it up. Actually, it was the longbow, sorry. But that was 26 meters. It hit the bone, and it still went to single lung. If it hadn't hit the bone, I think it might have gone to both lungs. That's something I'm gonna debate, but it's so close going to the second lung that I'm gonna say the bow slightly slowed it down. But even on that angle, it still did its job fairly well. And then we take a look at, now this time, the recurve bow. And the recurve is the more powerful from these guys, so that's a proper shot. And it is a long shot. And it already died. So let's pick it up. So when we pick it up, we can see that it went slightly back, my shot, but that penetration seems to be like slightly better or on par with the like CB65, I'm gonna say. But if you get a proper broadside shot on the red deer, it won't have any trouble to go double long shot. And then we compare all of these shots. So here we have the CB60, double long shot. Then we have the 65 in a bit of an angle, but it still took single lung. And then we have the CB70, which went both lungs. And then we have the crossbow. Just look at that. And then we have the longbow, which barely missed the second lung. And then the recurve also went to single lung. And then let's move on to the 600 and 700 grain arrows and do in the same order. We use the CB65 first. And I have some plains bisons over here. This guy is broadside, so I'm gonna take a shot at that. And that's a vital blood. These guys are gonna come. So let's take a shot at this guy first. There we go. Oh, he died. And then let's see what this guy is gonna do. And that's second hard shot. Okay, nice. And when we pick these guys up, yeah, the 600 grain arrows are insane. Straight in front, and it went through the whole animal. And same on this guy. Light, right lung, heart, liver, stomach, from the head on, and it went through the whole thing. And let's pick up this guy that I actually shot on the broadside shot. And as you can see, the bisons are big animals, and that was a bad angle, and it still penetrated all the way through. Like, as we saw with the 420 arrows, In this angle, they didn't go the second lung. The 600 grain arrows, it's like knife through butter. There's no stopping these guys. And then let's move on to the CB65. There's a bison at 25 meters. And I take a proper shot at that. The shot looked pretty much perfect. This guy is coming. Come on. And down it goes. So let's pick this guy up and see. Perfect double lung liver shot from 23 meters. I'm gonna say the recommended distances are just gonna be easy shots for the bows. I don't expect too much differences, especially with the bigger arrows, like the 600 and 700 grain arrows, because these are insane. And then we have more bison over here. That's like 20 meters. Pretty perfect. Use the CB70 on this one. Should be able to thread it between the bisons. Like right. Come on. There! Yeah, I got it. You can see there's a vital blood and it's, oh, jeez. And while I have it, I'm gonna say, trying, I took the recurve bow and used the 700 grain arrows while I'm at it. Holy crap, there's a lot of them. They are really peeved at me. So that guy died. There's one coming all the way. Like the 700 grain arrows are beast. This guy is perfect broadside. Gonna use the opportunity to take the recurve bow also. And down it goes. So let's start picking these guys up. And we see that this is the recurve bow. I mean, do I even need to do comparisons? That went through all the organs in the animal. And that's at like 23 meters. And then we pick up this guy. This with the CB70. Yeah, I just blast through the whole thing. So, pretty pointless, in my opinion, to do comparisons with these because they are extremely powerful weapons and the arrows. And then let's pick up all these others too that I shot. Double lung shot, 11 meters. Went through. And we have the other one with the recurve bow and look at that. Just look at that. And that's without the pumping iron. This again, roughly 20 meters. And I'm gonna use the longbow. Take a shot at it, shot at this guy. And it's a double lung shot, as expected. And down it goes, right there. And when we pick this guy up, we can see that it's same result. Easy penetration, easy double lung shot from the 20 meters. And here we have a level 4. I'm gonna use the crossbow on this one. Make it alert so it gets up and I can have a proper shot on the side. And that's a perfect double lung shot. And same with the 600 grain arrows. It's extremely effective. And when we pick up, we can see that it took lung, liver and stomach. It went a bit further back than I wanted, but it still did its job extremely well. And that's something I expected with the crossbow, because the bows already were so effective and the crossbow is like twice even more powerful than the bows. And when we start looking at these, we have first the CB60. from an angle, double long shot, no trouble at all. 65, no trouble at all. We have the CB70. You can see the pattern over here. And then we have the crossbow and trigger bow. And lastly, we have the longbow. There we go. This is insanity. So, in conclusion on the ultimate bow comparison part 1, if you use the recommended distance, all the bows are pretty similar in the penetration and damage. You can take down animals down pretty effectively. Even on a weird angles, the arrows are gonna have enough penetration to go to the lung if possible. Now on the part 2, I'm gonna test if distance is gonna make difference. So I'm gonna start taking shots like 60 meters and see if the arrows and the bows are gonna compare differently on the longer distance. I'm gonna think that's more interesting, because I'm gonna think the arrows with the bigger poundage are gonna penetrate further on the longer distance. So that's gonna be in the part 2 on the bow comparison. Thanks for watching, guys. Hit the like button if you found this video useful, and subscribe if you haven't already. And as always, have fun, happy hunting, and I see you at the next one. Bye bye.